40. You come a long way, Bobby. The big 4-0.
You just count your blessings. That's no big deal.
I'm just going to keep you so busy.
Forty's prime of life.
Have you seen a doctor?
Here you are, so successful and all. And you're still driving an old TV.
That's what I call giving the finger to the big 4-0.
That up for you?
It's not even my birthday.
Well, that doesn't matter.
I'd love it, but I think I'll have to pass.
Well, okay.
Have a nice day.
Same to you. Porsche 928. Ooh. Fastest production automobile in the whole damn world. This sucker will eat up anything on the road. Ferraris, Vets, you name it, man. The Porsche 928 will have them for breakfast. Yes, sir, it will.
How much?
A little over 40.
40?
Yeah.
1,000?
Uh-huh.
I have to talk to you. Bobby Lee, I just can't seem to make up my mind. I don't know if I should go or not.
Huh? Where?
With you and Becky to the airport. I don't know if I'm up to it.
I know I shouldn't be laying all this on you, Bobby, but I don't know what else to do. I've tried everything. TMS, cocaine. I can't talk to Ed or any of my friends. God, they're as miserable as I am. I need somebody to talk to. I've got to talk to you, Bobby.
Cowardly Burnett, I find you guilty of preventing your family from exercising their God-given right to tell you a bunch of shit you don't want to hear. And I sentence you to be the daddy, everybody's daddy, for the rest of your natural life.
Oh, hey, no, Dad, please.
Sorry, kiddo. That's just the way it goes.
Bobby, what's wrong?
I don't want to be the daddy. It's not fair. I'm too young.
He traded his big 98 Oldsmobile. He got a heck of a deal on a new Porsche car. He ain't wearing his usual gray business suit. He's got jeans and high boots with an embroidered star. And today he's 40 years old, going on 20. Don't look for the gray in his hair, 'cause he ain't got any. He's got a young thing beside him that just melts in his hand. He's middle-aged crazy, trying to prove he still can.
Does everything seem hopeless? Are you tired and defeated? Have you lost your head of mankind?
Oh,
then, pussy!
Hit it.
Miles.
What?
I think I can take him.
What are you talking about?
Porsche, there is no substitute.
Fuck you.
You warm enough?
I'm okay.
Was it something I said? God.
Get out the door! The keys are inside!
Oh, God. Please, stop! Stop! Stop!
Everybody, watch your feet.
Who's the U-boat commander?
No. They. That's her, man. That's you.
Right.
About time.
Frank got held up at the golf course, so he told me to come pick you up. He said he'd meet us at the track later. He said to bet on ice cream in the first, by the way.
In that thing? You must be kidding.
What are you talking? That's a Cadillac.
I wouldn't be caught dead in that thing.
Oh, come on, baby. You know, I mean, it's got a few years. But it's a cream puff.
It looks like somebody's nightmare.
So, you like this better?
Yeah.
You like one of them tigers from India?
Tigers, huh? Crazy guy. You know what he's been doing? Dragging me to the zoo to look at tigers. He says he's gonna buy one now. You do that, and you're not gonna have any friends left. Not that you have any now, but...
Well, you're gonna like that tiger, man.
I'm sure.
You gonna drive around with a tiger in your passenger seat, Tony?
Maybe. Some lady tiger. How much?
43,000, fully equipped.
That all?
Machine gun turrets are extra.
He's a funny guy. Come here, buddy. Bulletproof this, okay? And this here. And here.
Okay.
And the windows. Okay. And give me one of them phones, you know, with a scrambler.
scrambler.
And a radio with a scanners. Pick up flying saucers, stuff like that.
Don't forget the fog lights.
Oh, in case I get caught in a swamp. That's a good idea. Get out of the way, lady. We're trying to drive here, right?
I thought you were taking me to Frank.
We got an hour. You hungry?
No, but I'm bored.
Well, that figures. Hey, check it out, man, okay? You pay the guy.
Yeah.
And you take a taxi. Meet me at the track, okay? We're doing business with Montana. Oh, God! I wouldn't buy the car if you didn't like it.
Planning on driving the girls crazy, aren't you, Tony?
Oh, yeah. You know who?
I'm giving you orders. Blow.
Orders? You giving me orders?
Amigo, the only thing in this world that gives orders is balls. You got that? Balls.
Hammond and May think my 928 Porsche is a bit dull. But for one very good reason, it isn't dull to me.
You see, back in 1994, I was living in London. I got a call one evening from my mum to say that my dad was desperately ill in a hospital in Sheffield and I needed to get there as quickly as possible. I'd just taken a chicken out of the oven and I thought, well, I'll take that for my mum because she won't have eaten, ran outside, and I had a 928 on test that week. And when I arrived in Sheffield, the chicken was still warm, and my dad was still alive. In fact, he died half an hour later. And the truth is, if I hadn't have been driving a car which could sit quite happily at 170 miles an hour, I wouldn't have had the opportunity to say goodbye to my dad. So as far as I'm concerned, the 928 is all right.